most of academic research is almost certainly bullshit.
I'm shocked. Am I seeing a woman under the influence of free will?
This has nothing to do with free will.
I actually liked Sabine's video. I gave it a thumbs up and I gave her an encouraging comment. Coming back to my parody, I was really confused on the content of Sabine's most recent video because I had learned that she also thought that no free will can exist. Let's recapitulate what she told us.
Our decisions follow from what we want, and I think that's a good thing. If people knew free will does not exist, then they would think it does not matter what they do. If you act in ways that harm other people, then these other people will take steps to prevent that from happening again. I hope I have convinced you that free will is nonsense.
Thank you for the explanation. We definitely do agree on that one. Free will is absolute nonsense. I particularly like her simple consideration with the incentive on the one hand and the punishment on the other hand. So a person should always calculate which is bigger, the incentive or the punishment. There is no free will involved in any way. So why did Sabine go into physics in the first place? Let's take a look at the incentive and the punishment.
Sometimes heated, but usually respectful arguments. At school, I had always been the weird one for actually being interested in science and maths.
Taking into account these two statements, I am alarmed. Most girls Sabine's age value the punishment of being the weird one far bigger than the incentive of possible heated but respectful discussions in physics. I am very alarmed by the notion of free will in the young Sabine Hossenfelder. This is why I want to skip this period of her life and jump directly to the time when she received her master's degree and applied for a job position as a PhD student. Let's look at that.
The guy who was head of the institute told me that since I'm female, I should apply for a scholarship that was exclusively for women in the natural sciences, because then the institute wouldn't have to pay for me. Makes sense, doesn't it?
Yes, Sabine, this makes a lot of sense. The man did not have any punishment to fear, and he had an incentive. The incentive being more money. Sabine, I'm really happy that you found such a soulmate so early in your career. Let's look at the further development here.
The next problem was that the head of the institute made a lot of money selling textbooks. He wrote very little of these textbooks himself. Rather, he gave assignments for parts of the books to students and postdocs.
I am confused why this should be a problem, given that he has no punishment to fear and the incentive of making money. Should I be alarmed that this might be a sign of a rising free will in the young Sabine Hossenfelder again?
He expected me to also work for him, to which I said no. He started shouting that I was fired and physically shoved me out of his office. True story.
Yes, this is a true story, and I am a fan of the head of the institute because he does not show any sign of free will. He does not have any punishment to fear at all. So his behavior is in perfect accordance with the absence of free will.
The irony is that he couldn't fire me because, if you remember, he had refused to hire me in the first place. I was paid by that scholarship for women, and that wasn't managed by the institute, but by the office of the university president.
This changes the consideration. On the incentive side, Sabine can now also make a connection with the president of the university. While on the punishment side, she does not have to fear losing her job anymore.
The more I saw of this, the more I realized this wasn't how I wanted to spend my life. And naive as I was, I expected physicists to think about it. I expected rational debate. But that never came. No one was interested. No one is interested. They were interested in writing more papers.
Well, Sabine, here I am really confused because these physicists show absolutely no free will at all. They want to write more papers and they don't want to have discussions where free will might occur. I am proud of these physicists and I don't know what you are complaining about.
Meanwhile, I had moved half around the world because that's standard for postdocs. It's just expected of you. And at some point, you just accept the constant moving as normal because the only people you know also do it. It's incredibly hostile to personal life, detrimental to mental health.
This sounds like the perfect treadmill with the absolute absence of free will. Sabine should be feeling like she's in paradise right now. Why is she not super happy?
After 5 years of my murder commute, I just couldn't do it anymore. My mental health was worse than ever. I was permanently stressed out. I was feeling guilty for not working more and not spending more time with my kids. I had several nervous breakdowns. I was constantly ill.
Now here I get really alarmed. Sabine already fulfilled her reproduction needs and she had her children already. But still, she somehow suggests that she was not happy, even though there was a total absence of free will going on in her life. What should we think of this?
I wrote the papers, I wrote my reports, and the reports were approved. Normal academic procedure. But I knew it was
very likely the best research of her entire life. Consider this. She was in an environment without any free will at all.
Unofficially, on the side, I do the research that I thought was worth my time, but that I couldn't get money for because it was too far off the mainstream.
Now, here I am confused again. Why would she make research alongside her other research? There is a very small incentive of researching a topic that she will never publish any paper on, and the punishment of just possibly developing free will again. Shocking.
This sounds like a sad story, and in some sense it is, because it's the story of a young scientist whose dream died.
Sabine, I am confused. Why do you say your dream died? You have a lot of arguments with physicists that do not show any sign of any free will. How else should they behave to make you happy?
And it's the story of an old scientist who thinks they could have made a difference if it hadn't been necessary to get past 5 reviewers who didn't share my interests, because that's what it comes down to eventually.
Sabine, the reviewers don't have any free will. They only value incentive and punishment. You should be very happy that you have business with these reviewers.
It's not that they say there's something wrong with your proposal. It just doesn't excite them because it's not the main current interest.
The main current interest is that the idea of free will is nonsense, as you told us. And we want to live in a world without any free will at all.
There's a happy ending in that I found you, a community of people who share my interests. Well, more or less. Or why the heck have you not been watching my video on indefinite causal structures?
Because this topic has a hard time finding financial support in the form of grants. And we don't want to deal with any topic with such problems because we are physicists without any free will.
I know many people who love academia the way it is and who think it's working just fine. I'm just not one of them. Have never been, and I don't think I'll ever be.
Why not, Sabine? Try to have less free will. You will be a happier person.
I'm not sure if I'm going to post this video.
You posted the video now, and it was a good decision. We are physicists without any free will. If the YouTube algorithm recommends your video, we are going to watch it because we simply don't have any free will.
I hope I have convinced you that free will is nonsense and that the idea deserves going into the rubbish bin.
Thanks for watching the video. See you in my next video. Until then, bye.